Isaiah chapter number 61, verse 1 to 3. The good news of salvation. Isaiah chapter number 61, verse number 1 to verse number 3. The heading there is the good news of salvation. Verse 1. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to console those who mourn in Zion, to give them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they may be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified. Heavenly Father, we come to you, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We come to you, O God, in the mighty name of our Savior, our Redeemer, Yeshua HaMashiach, the name of our Lord, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, we come to you, we humble ourselves before your throne this morning during this first watch of this day in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for your word. Namhlanje kuseni sibonga izwi lakho uNkulunkulu nomusa, izwi lakho that gives us hope, izwi lakho that gives us faith, izwi lakho baba wethu engcwele lisiguqulayo. Kuqule ucabanga kwethu, kuqule baba wethu engcwele, our walk, Heavenly Father. Siyabonga izwi lakho namhlanje lisiphilisayo, elisazosipha ukuphila, our eternal life, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you for your Holy Spirit, God, who comforts and helps us to understand your holy word. May you speak through us, Heavenly Father. From a heart of stone to a heart of flesh, Heavenly Father, even as we receive your eternal word, in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Bangcwele, sanibingelela ngegama elihle, namfeli wethu uKristu uJesu namhlanje kuseni. Sasiphi izwi lakhe uIsaiah chapter number 61, bangcwele besifunda in New King James Version namhlanje kuseni. Siyabonga, sivuka nezwi nomyalezo obalulekile namhlanje kuseni of salvation, bazalwane. God says in his word that ufisa ukuthi wonke umuntu asindiswe, and that every person receives salvation. What is salvation, bazalwane? Salvation is that each and every one of us accepts and believes in Christ Jesus. So the hope and the desire of our God is that each and every one of us receives Jesus Christ as our Savior, as our Messiah, that we believe that Jesus Christ is the only begotten Son of our God, that Jesus Christ descended from heaven over 2,000 years ago. He descended from heaven, he came to earth, he preached salvation. If we read the book of Matthew chapter number 4, that is where Jesus Christ started his ministry, bangcwele, at the age of 30, and he preached for 3 years. He gave his life, he gave over his spirit, his soul to the Father in heaven at the age of 33, bazalwane. He died for us on the cross, bangcwele. He was in the tomb for 3 days, and after 3 days, on the third day, he rose bodily from the tomb. And after 40 days, bazalwane, he was witnessed on earth by people that were living on earth, that he rose bodily. Babona izandla zakhe, babona inyawo zakhe, they saw his wounds, bazalwane. And then he ascended to heaven where he is seated at the right hand of God the Father. So salvation is us receiving Jesus Christ as Messiah, believing that he died and rose from the dead, that he is seated now at the right hand of God. So when we receive him, when Mrs. Vuma ngemlomo yethu, sikholwe enhlizweni bese siyavuma ngemlomo yethu, Romans chapter number 10, that Jesus Christ is Lord, bazalwane, when we have heard izwi lakhe, the gospel, the gospel of truth, bangcwele, because believing comes from hearing and hearing of the word of God, and then receiving and admitting ngezwi ngamazwi ethu ngemlomo yethu ukuthi uJesu Christ, he is the Messiah, he has come, and that he will come back the second time for his church now. The word of God tells us in the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter number 4 that we will be caught up in the clouds with him, together with him. He will come with a great shout together with his angels, bangcwele, ukuthi when he comes to uzolanda ibandla lakhe, bazalwane. So that is salvation, bangcwele, and believing in Christ Jesus and Christ Jesus alone, bangcwele, no one else but Christ Jesus alone, the power that is in him to resurrect us, bazalwane. Because the word of God tells us that we will be resurrected wherever we are. Nabasolwandle bangcwele bazovuka, their spirit, their souls bazovuka, bangcwele, those that are dead in Christ, dead in Christ, bazalwane, bazovuka and join Christ Jesus in the air, bangcwele. So that is salvation. And God is saying namhlanje kuseni that he's reminding us that his wish, bangcwele, is that his hope is that every man is saved. Every man is saved, bazalwane, hayi abathile. But he created all of us so that we can spend eternal life with him, with God the Father, with Christ Jesus, with God's Holy Spirit in heaven, bazalwane. When we have ruled with him 1,000 years, la emhlabeni, bangcwele, but God's wish is that all of us, bazalwane, are saved, bangcwele. And so he's given us Isaiah chapter number 61, namhlanje, and he has urged us to share a dream. I'm going to say a dream. Angazi ukuthi bekuyi dream or bekuyiphupho or bekuyi angazini umbono othile, because God then allowed us to be in this room where this was happening, hence the word or the message that he's given to us namhlanje ngomusa wakhe, because God sometimes allows us to see what is happening in the spiritual realm, bangcwele, ngomusa wakhe. It's only by grace that God sometimes takes us to see, bangcwele, as his people, as his prophets, to see what is happening in the spiritual realm, bangcwele. So this is a dream that asinikezelo na, even in our sleep, we know, bazalwane, ukuthi this body, this carnal body, may go to sleep, may go to rest, but our spiritual man is awake at all times, because our spirits and our souls do not die, and they do not go to sleep. Bangcwele, so this is a dream ubaba wethu asinike lona, but we didn't really sleep ebusuku. So angazi ukuthi, I'm just calling it a dream, but umbono that God took us to see in the spiritual realm. So as we were resting, bangcwele, in the night, bazalwane, so God took us eyosibonisa ukuthi what is happening in the spiritual realm, which is something that is very heavy that God allowed us to see in the Fungu Nesindayo, that abantu bakhe are being lured to go and join just because omubi usathane namadimona akhe ubathembisa imali abathembise ngizothini iprosperity emfishane emhlabeni ngoba siyazi ukuthi ezwini lakhe ubaba wethu uyasitshela ukuthi washo before the flood and after the flood wathi he will not alwe nabantu, hence the flood, bazalwane. And then Noah and his family were chosen to survive so that the human race may start from scratch because there was so much evil in the world. And ubaba wethu what he will not struggle with human beings. And he said he will give them 100 years. And then we find in the book of Psalms, God saying that he will give human beings 70 years, and then he says 80 years because of strength by the grace of God. So what God is saying that he will give us 70 years or 80 years if he gives us that strength, Bangwele, because he says he will not strive with the evil that is in the world, Bangwele. Imagine, for instance, if Hitler was allowed to live for, in the beginning, people lived for 500, 700, when we read the book, the Word of God, Bazalwane, even 900 years, Bangwele. So imagine if a person like Hitler was allowed today to live 900 years, the evil that they would bring into the world. Sekunale technology namhlanje, the evil that they would cause la emhlabeni. So God is saying, because of the evil that is in the world, God is saying he's giving us 70 or 80 years by his grace. Ngomusa khona bahlala no 100 years. We don't know why. Ama secrets ankulunkulu lokho uthi Jehova, he reveals what he wants us to know, what he wants his prophets to know, but konke okwakhe, he reveals what he wants us to know, and his secrets he keeps secrets. So some may die at 70, some may die at 120, some may die at 10 years old. So asazi bantwele, there are premature deaths as well because of the evil that is in the world. So God allowed us and took us ebusuku salele bantwele to show us the plans of the enemy in trying to lure God's people away from Christ Jesus, away from salvation, away from him. Wahao, by the promises of wealth, Bangwele, abazo enjoy for a short time in this world, but then these people must sell their souls to the evil one. People then end up selling their souls to Satan, selling their souls to the kingdom of darkness. Why? Because of le tembiso ezimfishane ezasemhlabeni ezemali. So God took us, and we were in this meeting, bazalwane, where Satan and his demons, the kingdom of darkness, ubethembisa abantu imali, bazalwane. And so we were in this place, kunendawo. So once umuntu esevumile to join this, I'm going to say a cult, but it is in the kingdom of darkness, they would receive something like a suitcase or suitcase that also looked like a cage. And within this suitcase that looked also like a cage, there was a record player. If you think back, bazalwane, tinale sakula gama 80s, bantwele, kwa gama record player. So when you wanted to listen to music, utenga ma record, bantwele, bakulu nje, emnyama, and then there was a record player in an pin where you begi pin la bayana, and then begi record, begi press, play, besi ya raundi record, ilalu music. So in this occult, in this kingdom of darkness, this person, mesevumile, uyijoyina, would receive the suitcase that looked like a cage with a record player inside. But also within this thing, this cage-like suitcase that had a record player, there was an animal inside that looked like a dog. But it wasn't your normal domesticated dog. It'd be strange, Injayakon. So within this, there's the record player that would play music, and there's sort of a dog within. So once this person opened this compartment, this dog would be released, Bazalwane, which was like Ipume Lenja, Ipume with evil spirits in it. So we were there, Bangwele Sibone, and this case compartments would be delivered where umude shala khona. It looked like flats, yabo bazalwane. So it was delivered, and I was there. And when it was delivered, these two men came to collect it, bazalwane. So it was delivered where I was. So these two men that this case was addressed to, bafika bathayike bazolanda case yabo. Ngithi mina ningayivuli le case. Sithi ningayivuli le case ngoba meniyivula kuzophuma lenja lena, and lenja iphuma namademon. And once you open this case, once you open this compartment, once you open this suitcase, you can never go back again. Once this dog is released, siyabatshela, you can never go back again. This dog will never be able to go back to this. They will never say, they will never agree to go back. Hayi, labantu bathi hayi bazoyivula bona le case, bayayifuna. Hayi, they took it back. I'm trying to fight, you're trying to fight. Don't open it. Hayi, bayivula, iphume lenjani. It looked like a black bulldog, but strange, with some strange power. So bayivula. And mese bayivulile, there was no turning back. Mese iphumile lenja, then there were instructions that came with the release of this dog and the powers of this dog. So now they were walking, and but then mese bayivulile, I'm trying to remember also because I can't remember all of this dream. Then we were walking, but as we were walking, it's like those that had opened and released this dog, they received some strange car, but this car didn't have tires. So in an armata, it had like intambo. Instead of tires, it had intambo. But as le moto yabo ihamba, lezi intambo ziyaqashuka, which means this car that they received as well did not have power, ziyaqashuka. Kodwa mele ihamba, they were being promised money, bazalwane. So within this kingdom of darkness, within this account, as abantu bebizwa to come and join. So there was a meeting, Bangwe. There was a meeting in this room. And within this room that God allowed us to be in, so everyone had a backpack. Within this backpack, konizinto ifakiwe phakathi ukuthi people must agree. Uthi when they agree, bafika abantu that were recruiting, bazalwane. And they showed them, ukuthi, last year they made 19 billion rand or 19 billion dollars, but it was 19 billion. So these people were excited. Ah, 19 billion, I'm going to receive this money. We were sitting there, we're like, but don't do that. And beside me was a person, it was a lady that I used to work with in the previous work. Secular work that I was working in bazalwane, and she was concentrating as these people were speaking. She's going to sign this deal because she wants this money. I'm looking at her, I'm like, but don't sign it. And she has this 19 billion rand or dollars or euros, but a lot of money, and they were handing out La man notes, which you will make a lot of money because they made 19 billion. So people were excited, and they were given these backpacks with these instructions. So in their minds, money was just being drilled in them, so they had to sign. And a lot of people.
So this person, this lady, so I don't know if God is saying it's this lady that was wants to sign her into this account, or it is she represented the workplace, the circular workplace that I used to work in recently. Ukuthi people are joining in this workplace or in different workplaces as well, by the way. But God will reveal it to us. So God is just saying, bazalwane, ungavumi nomoya wakho. So means Vugek said, my heart was just heavy. So I went to pray in our prayer closet, Bangwen. And God is just saying, pray for salvation. Pray for salvation. Why? Because people's souls are being sold to the enemy because of the promise of money. People are selling their souls because of the promise of false wealth, by the way, around the world. Bazalwane, usathane uthembisa abantu imali engeke futhi izilaste noma ungawuphila lo 70 years. Kodwa ngezilaste wogcina ufile, wogcina ushonile, wogcina uhambile, wayishiya mhlambe leyo mali meyisakhona, but you would have lost your soul, bazalwane. So God is saying to us this morning, don't sell your soul to the kingdom of darkness because of the promises of false wealth, Bangwe. What will you gain in selling your soul and losing your soul and gaining some kind of wealth? Noma ngabe yiwona lo 19 billion, trillion, zillion dollars or euros or whatever it is, but it is not worth your soul, Bangwe. It is not worth your soul. So God allowed us to be in that meeting where God's people were in, be recruitwa, bazalwane, to sell their souls because of money. It is not worth it, bazalwane. It is not worth it, Bangwe. Whatever you have, be content with it. We see in the walk where Jesus Christ was in the world, living in the world, not in the world, but was living in the world in this carnal flesh, bazalwane, that naye he lived kunzima, Bangwe. Kunzima usathane khona, Matthew chapter number 4, ezama ngayo yonke indlela kumdistracta, but he used the word of God, ukunqoba, Bangwe. He even said in his word, he said that the Son of Man has no roof over his head, but because he knew in the book of John, he says, when he prayed, when Jesus Christ prayed for us, for you and me, for the body of Christ, for the church, he said to God the Father, I don't pray that you take them out of the world, but I pray that you give them strength in the world. Bangwele, there are difficulties in the world for all of us. Akekho umuntu ophila nje in a summer season. There are different seasons in life, Bangwele. Njengoba sikhuluma right now, iwinter iyangena, kuyabanda, sizogodola. But kusho ukuthini? Kusho ukuthi go be prepared for winter. Buy a jacket, get a jacket. Ask for a jacket if you can't buy one. We should prepare for every season. How do we prepare for every season? Spiritually, we pray in summer when it is warm, when we do not need a jacket, when we do not need upoloneko, when we do not need boots, when umesagqoka ama shorts, sagqoka ama vest, it doesn't mean ukuthi hayi because it's summertime, samnandi saswima, hayi wiku siyakhohlwa ukuthandaza, siyakhohlwa ukufasta, cha, in every season We pray for seasons to come, Bantwe. If in winter, prepare for some. Ngiyakugqoka ijazi ngesamu uzojuluka ube kube ngeke ukwazi ukugqoka. So prepare for every season, bazalwane. And in life there are different seasons. There are seasons of lack, there are seasons of plenty, there are seasons where you are just be content in the season where you are in. In every season, God is teaching us something. In every season, Jesus Christ is building up our character. In every season, Holy Spirit is teaching us and removing things of the world. In every season, Jesus Christ is teaching us about ourselves. Perhaps we are selfish. Perhaps asabangi. Perhaps we are rude. Perhaps as kolwakahle. Perhaps he needs to increase our faith. Whatever he is doing in that season, bazalwane, we need to sit in that season and listen to God's Holy Spirit and be humble, bantwe, in that season. Singajahizi ndengakafiki kuthina. Singafuni izinto esingabekelwe zona. We are different. God has created us as different vessels. He says in his word, some vessels are for honor. Some vessels are for daily use. Bantwele, perhaps I'm a vessel for daily use and I'm not a vessel for honor that needs to shine. Ekufanele ibe mhlambe igolide noma ama diamond mhlambe ujoke ungibekele mina ukuthi nje for daily use. Bazalwane, a daily, now we are sazi sitsho sisebenzisa every day mo udla lapha endlini. Khona isitsho sisebenzisa every day, khona isitsho ozosikhiphela abavakashi abantu mebevakashile. Uyazi-ke ukuthi lezi ayisengikhiphe ikhatlari yami ephambili eyigolide mhlambe eyisilver. Kodwa uma siyidlela la ekhaya, siyidlela nje noma ingakusiphi isipuni, siyidlela ngo-tupperware, siyidlela ngeplastiki engenagama ngoba siyithe for daily use. But uma sekufike mhlambe abavakashi abathile, umema abantu, mhlambe i-birthday yengane, usukhipha lokho okuphambili. Maybe you are for daily use, maybe we are vessels of daily use, maybe we are vessels of honor ezohlotshiswa ngayo. Asazi bantwele, Jesus Christ is the potter. We cannot tell him ukuthi sifuna ukwenza asikwazi ukuyikhethela. Ukuthi mina ke Jehova ngifuna ukuba ubishop, mina ngifuna ukuba umprofeti, mina ngifuna asikwazi ukuyikhethela. Mhlambe enkonzweni wena ukuthi nje uintercessor. That for me, that's a high place. Because you are communicating to God. You are not the pastor. You are the intercessor. You pray for the pastor so that God reveals himself to the pastor or bishop or whoever it is. Perhaps you are the bishop. Asaz bangwe. But asingajahi sifune izinto engazona zethu nezinto esingabekelwe zona solimala. Paul says in the word of God that I have learned to be content. He says that in the word of God. He says, I have learned to be content, whether in plenty or in lack. Bangwe. Whether in plenty or in lack. Noma ngabe unemali, noma ngabe awunayo, noma ngabe ukwiposition ethile emsebenzini, noma ngabe awunayo, be content where God has placed you in this season. Seasons change. Don't sell your soul for imali, bangwele. This is painful, bazalwane, what we are seeing in the world. It is painful. Abantu bayathwala. Abantu bayojoyina izinto ezingaziwa, bayathakatha. Bayagaba, bayagquma, bayaphalaza. Lezo zinto aziphuma nemithetho yakhona. Ongekwazi ukuyimela. Kuzodingeka ukuthi uzubuyele kuJehova ukuze akukline. Why put yourself in that kind of burden? In that kind of bondage Why choose to put yourself in that kind of bondage? Fanele uhlabe imbuzi, uhlabe njalo nesikhathi esithile, fanele uyogeza emfuleni othile, uhlabe imbuzi, wenze give out imali, awunakho nje ukuphumula emphefumulweni. There's no peace in those things, bazalwane. Come to Jesus Christ. He is our peace, bazalwane. He is our peace. And just pray to him. He says in the book of Matthew, when the disciples asked him to teach them how to pray, he says, ask for daily bread. On a daily basis, we ask for daily bread. Adinge ukuthi sesiyontshontsha manje usufuna ukuyontshontsha usuqhumisa imoto zemali sewuyadutshulwa laphayana all because of money usufela emanyaleni nje ngoba ugijimisa imali yehlisa umoya mzalwane yehlisa umoya uthemba uJesu Kristu vele kuzoba ney'nkinga it is difficult emhlabeni it is tough but okwethu ukuthi sikhuleke okwethu ukuthi sikholwe kuKristu Jesu. For instance, there's a season in my life where I lived in back rooms, not one bedroom, and I'm not saying in a one bedroom house, in a back room, one room. There's a kitchen, there's a la istofu, la umbede, la TV mengi nayo. Now in one room, in someone's home, back rooms, in a season, I think it was for 2 years. In back rooms, by the way. It was a season for me. Maybe it was a testing season to see. Ukuthi when usazothi uyamkhetha yini lo Jesu ungenalutho. Nearly lost everything. During COVID, had to go back home in 2021 and live with my mother. My mother had to take care of me. My sisters had to take care of us. Even if that, I had to be, so that I could preach. My family had to ukuthembela kumndeni wami, rely on my family to buy 10 gigs. Of data so that I can go online and preach the word of God. I didn't have the 200 rand. It was 159 rand. I didn't have it. It was a season, bazalwane, from back rooms to back home for 2 years. So seasons come and go, bandwe. Oh, don't despair. Because ubona abanye ukuthi sebehamba ngale moto sebegqoka ukuthi izinto engenamsebenzi lezo ozoyishiya emhlabeni igama elithi the only name that we must be happy to put on ourselves is the name of Jesus Christ. That is the only name that we must rejoice to wear. The only name, the only brand that is worthy to put on ourselves, the only name that is worthy of us to wear is the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Igama lomunye umuntu odayi or designer whatever is means nothing in your life, means nothing in our lives, bangcwele. So we need to have renewed minds. We need to ask God to renew our minds, to take us out. The word of God says, we have been taken out of this world. Taken, we live carnally in this world, but fundamentally, we are spirits, bazalwane. And our spirit will live forever. Our spirit will not, that spirit doesn't die. Your soul doesn't die. So we need to choose, namhlanje. Where we want our souls to be eternally. Because eternally your soul will either be in heaven or in hell. Either in heaven or in hell, bazalwane. Choose namhlanje. That I choose my soul. I choose to spend eternity in life with Christ Jesus, bazalwane. Not in death, in hell. Don't sell your soul for things. Usudayisa ngomzimba ngoba nakufuna imali. Eh? No, don't do that. Fanele ube ne boyfriend, fanele ube no sugar daddy, fanele ube no sugar mama, ngoba ufuna ukudrayiva leya moto, ngoba ufuna ukubonwa emphakathini, sudayisa ngomzimba, udayisa with your soul because usuthiwa yini igold digger. Ngoba ufuna ukufaka lezi inwele eyibizayo, ufuna ukufaka inzipho, ufuna ukubonakala, ufuna ukuya endaweni eyithile angazi kodwa ubaqha. Yes, Isumo, if you are meant to go on holiday in Dubai, it's fine. God will just give you the money for you to go. You don't need to sell your body for it. Don't need, the Bible says that every kind of sin that man commits is outside the body. But the sexual sin, God says, then you are sinning against your own body. Bazalwane. When we commit sexual sin, sexual immorality, one is then committing a sin against one's body. You walk with it wherever you are. Soul ties. By the way, don't do that to yourself. Because of money. Because you want to shine for a season. Don't do that. God once showed me someone. He was a popular singer. I'm sleeping and God gives me a vision of this person. I won't name them. They were a popular, I'm going to say, gospel singer, as we knew them. And then they passed away, like a few years ago, couple of years ago. So after that, God gives me a vision of this person. I'm seeing them. Umile emhlabeni. So he's standing, and uphethe I for sure. And ugqoke izinto ezibrown in the vision, this person. Umile uphethe ifosholo, ngathi he's digging his own hole, bangcwele, kuthiwa ingcwaba. He's digging ingcwaba lakhe, this is after he died. Ugqoke izinto ezibrown, ungcolile nje, and he's looking up with a sad face. And God told me, this person sold his soul because he wanted fame on earth. But that fame only lasted for a few years. Washon, waf. And he, ukushona kwakhe wagula. Washon. He dug his own grave by selling his own soul to the devil. For fame. By the way, don't choose that path. God is saying, namhlanje, choose life. Choose eternal life. By the way, let us read from Isaiah chapter number 61. This is the NIV. By the way, let's read God's word. And then we'll move into prayer. Let's all pray for ourselves. Let us pray for the world. Let us pray for our communities. Let us pray, bangcwele, for our families, bazalwane, that every person receives salvation. Balekile. We must choose now. Sisaphile emhlabeni ukuthi we are choosing Christ Jesus. We are choosing eternal life, bangcwele. Don't sell your soul, bazalwane. Please, don't, because of things. Don't do this. No matter what, it is not worth it. It is not. So, Isaiah chapter number 61. This is the NIV, Bangwele. And the heading here is the year of the Lord's favor. Verse 1. The spirit of the sovereign Lord is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. God is giving us, he's bringing us good news, namhlanje. Good news of salvation. Good news of eternal life, bangcwele. To proclaim good news to the poor, he has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted. To proclaim freedom for the captive. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted. Namhlanje, your heart could be broken. Bangcwele ubone ngathi akuhambi kahle. Ubone ngathi akuhlangani. Yonke imizamo oyizamayo akuhlangani nje uloku uzamile uthi hayi kodwa baba okay ngizoma ezwini lakho ngenze ngenzo ukubi uloku uzamile uya apply uyasebenza akuhlangani njena your heart is broken God is saying namhlanje he's bringing you and me good news bazalwane in his word that namhlanje his favor is upon us his favor is upon us bangwele whatever is in your heart that you would love to do that he has placed in your heart he's saying he's surrounding you with favor as a shield bazalwane he's saying namhlanje enough is enough he's saying he heard your prayer he's saying he heard your prayer he's saying he saw you crying wherever you are he's saying he saw your tears ulele embedeni he's saying he's answering your prayer he's answering our prayers your heart has been broken you are trying by all means to stand in the word of God but you were seeing no results he's saying namhlanje he's bringing you results in the mighty name of Jesus perhaps your prayer has been hindered by demonic spirits God is saying he has conquered he has sent his holy angels to conquer bangwele demonic spirits and your answer has arrived in the mighty name of Jesus all you need to do is stand on God's promises stand on God's word in the mighty name of Jesus God is saying the heartbrokenness he's taking it away namhlanje in the mighty name of Jesus he's bringing us good news namhlanje because his promises are yes and amen his promises are true his word is true because his word does not come back to him void he watches over his word to perform it bangwele his word is true namhlanje so he's saying look up to him namhlanje we must look up to him and know and believe bazalwane that his word is true and believe bangwele that we have received bazalwane the answers that we have been looking for in the mighty name of Jesus I'm reminded of Daniel when he was fasting and praying for 3 weeks bazalwane for 21 days when the angel came at the bank at the river where he was praying he said God heard your prayer was heard the first day that you prayed but it was the principles in the heavenly realm that try to hinder the answer so God is saying your prayer was heard the first day that you prayed perhaps the angels the demonic angels were trying to hinder you were trying to hinder that answer from reaching you but God's answer is reaching has reached you namhlanje in the mighty name of Jesus we need to stand in the word of God Ephesians chapter number 6 tells us to stand after standing stand bazalwane we need to stand our answers need to reach us need to come to us in the place of prayer our answers need to reach us bangwele in our sanctuaries where God where we is with us where we meet bazalwane with God the Father where we communicate bangwele with God the Father do not move do not lose your position in prayer bangwele do not lose it because you do not see things happening carnally we are spiritual beings and our prayers are being answered spiritually bangwele don't sell your soul to the kingdom of darkness choose Christ Jesus namhlanje bangwele because perhaps you are thinking my mother used to pray my grandmother used to pray and yet they died as poor people I'm saying to you namhlanje if you have Christ Jesus in your life, there is no poverty. You are wealthy, Bangwele. Even if you died praying in one room, living in a shack, but you are a wealthy person. I'm reminded of Lazarus, Bazalwane. In the world, he had sores. He had no food. He sat outside on a gate, Bangwele. But the Bible tells us that when he died, his soul, his spirit was carried by angels to the bosom of Abraham. It means that his spirit was carried into heaven, into paradise, Bangwele. So even if it looks like you do not have anything in this carnal world, but as long as you have Christ Jesus, who is Tebi Bazalwane, you are rich, you are wealthy, Bangwele. Receive Christ Jesus in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Do not think in your mind, which I have seen people praying all their lives, but abazange babe naluto. Bangwele, we are reminded of King David, Bazalwane. He had to fight ama enemies of God. He had to fight. He was king, but he had to fight, and the generations that came after him, his sons, King Solomon, the Bible declares that there was peace when King Solomon ruled and reigned, Bazalwane, on Israel, Bangwele. So perhaps those that you saw dying without any carnal wealth, perhaps they were the Davids of your family, and you are Solomon. They were building a foundation for you and I, Bangwele, so that we could be saved, so that we could walk, Bangwele, and believe in Christ Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Verse 1, Isaiah 61 says, to proclaim freedom for the captives and release from darkness for the prisoners, Bangwele. To proclaim freedom for the captives, Bazalwane. You see, when you are in the kingdom of darkness, you are a captive, Bangwele. You are a captive, Ngoba. You are in bondage, Bazalwane. As soon as you do it and say yes to the kingdom of darkness and do those rules and rituals that they do, and then you are bound in the thing. You are a captive, Bazalwane. You are in prison because they tell you what to do, what time to wake up, what to slaughter, what to do. What bondage is that? Bazalwane, fagi panda. Instead of choosing Jesus Christ, Bangwele, and just read his word and just believe. It is free, Bazalwane. U Jesu Christu says fele, esiphambanweni. This salvation is free, Bazalwane. It is free. Mkhethe u Jesu Christu namhlanje, where you are. You don't need to walk down a huge church. If you did that, it's fine. But God is saying, even in the room where you are, you can receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You just need to believe. You and I need to believe that Jesus Christ is the Messiah, and then believe and read his word and walk according to his commandments, and then you will receive, we will receive eternal life, Bangwele. What a glorious life. What a wonderful life, Bangwele. That worry that you have on a daily basis. What shall I eat? Well, in little Bible, in the book of Matthew, do not worry what to eat or what you will wear. Utu Baba Oto says, he takes care of even birds and gonke or corner, Bangwele. How much more you and me? How much more you and me? He says he knows the number of hairs in our heads, Bangwele. He says he knits us in our mother's wombs, Bazalwane. He cares for you. He loves you. He created you and me in his image and in his likeness, Bazalwane. So God loves you. Be content where you are. God will pull you out. Verse 2 of Isaiah chapter number 61. to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. We proclaim in the mighty name of Jesus that God's favor shall find you this year. God's favor shall locate you and surround you this year. In the mighty name of Jesus, we proclaim, we declare this year the year of God's, the Lord's favor. We declare that this year, all of your dreams, bazalwane, konke lokho okusebenzele, all of your hard work, bazalwane, will come into fruition, bangwele. Kuzobonakala, uNkulunkulu uzozibonakalisa ngawe, uzobonakalisa amandla akhe ngempilo yakho, bangwele, because of your faithfulness, because you stood in the word of God, because you stood in the promises of God, uNkulunkulu will show off his power, he will show off his grace, he will show off his favor. We speak it over your life in the mighty name of Jesus. We speak God's favor in everything that you touch. May everything that you touch in every area of your life turn to gold in the mighty name of Jesus. We know that gold doesn't lose bangwele value yayo. We know that God, this is why the word of God is likened to gold, because gold doesn't lose bazalwane value yayo bangwele, ayiphucuki, ayilose favor in value, instead it goes up. So we speak God's favor over every area of your life in the mighty name of Jesus. We speak that everything that you touch turns to gold in Jesus' mighty name, and that your spirit is renewed and that your mind is renewed in the mighty name of Jesus. Even as you choose Jesus Christ today, even if you choose him today, we speak God's revelation over your life in the mighty name of Jesus. We speak God's wisdom that comes from heaven. We speak it now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ as we receive the favor of God in Jesus' name, and the release from darkness for prisoners, to proclaim the Lord's year of favor and the day of vengeance of our God, so that the enemy, God, may release his vengeance towards the enemy, towards the evil one, towards the demonic spirits that wants to lure God's people away from Jesus Christ. May God's vengeance be upon the kingdom of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus. May God's judgment be upon the kingdom of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus. May God's rebuke be upon the kingdom of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus. Even as we receive the favor of God in Jesus' mighty name. Verse 3, and provide for those who grieve in Zion. Providing for those who grieve in Zion. If you are grieving, God is assuring us, namhlanje, whatever you are going through, whatever lack may have presented itself in your life, God is saying namhlanje that he is providing for us. Whatever has been lacking in your life, in our lives, God is saying he's providing for us in Zion, in the mighty name of Jesus. There is no lack in the kingdom of God. We speak abundance in every area in the mighty name of Jesus. We speak overflow in every area of your life in the mighty name of Jesus. May God's blessings reach you and overtake you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Whatever you've been lacking, we speak God's providence over your life in the mighty name of Jesus. May your cup overflow in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May it overflow. God's blessings overflow and catch up and overtake you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, to the glory of God, Bazalwane, even as we stand in the word of God, even as we choose Christ Jesus, even as we walk according to the commandments of God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Asigcwalise ngezwi lakhe umoya ingcwele ahambe nathi asiphe ukuhlakanipha okuvele ezulwini ngaso sonke isikhathi. In the mighty name of Jesus, we speak salvation in your home. In the mighty name of Jesus, that every person that needs salvation in your community, in your life, in your family, in the workplace, bazalwane, we plead the blood of Jesus in our workplaces. We plead the blood of Jesus in our churches, bangwele, in the mighty name of Jesus, that the salvation of God but may reach every person in the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that was trying to eat your everything in your God is giving me a vision that someone bangwele in your home doesn't last, bangwele. So God is saying, whatever the enemy had been doing in your home, bazalwane, he's removing that in the mighty name of Jesus. He's removing, bangwele, leso silwane, leso besidla, bangwele, your food, bazalwane, in the mighty name of Jesus. And just reminding us, bangwele, that when we buy our groceries, we need to pray over them. Mesfike emakhaya before ukufaka ekhabetheni ukudla kwakho, plead the blood of Jesus Christ over your food in the mighty name of Jesus. Perhaps there was something that the enemy had planted in your home to come and destroy and eat, bazalwane, even igundwane, mobona igundwane, bazalwane, in your home. Plead the blood of Jesus in your home. It is not a good sign ukuhlala namagundwane. Igundwane is a destroyer. Okuqala nje linuka kambi, okwesibili liyadla limoshe. And I'm reminded of a vision and a dream. I'm going to say a vision that God gave me. Bazalwane, we are in this place. It was about a month or two back. It's like I was in this, in our home, bangwele. And Ubabukhoza was with us as well. And I was in the kitchen. Ubabukhoza came with someone. And this person just, in ministry, bangwele, this is a vision, bazalwane. And I'm in the kitchen preparing food for them. And as soon as this person in the ministry that came with Ubabukhoza was in the kitchen with me preparing food, suddenly out of the wall, bangwele, in the kitchen came out a huge rat, bazalwane. And this rat yaphuma yazowela, and it yahamba emva kwami and fell pants, and then yaphuma ngomnyango, bangwele. And then God said, it is done, bazalwane. So perhaps whatever it is that the enemy had tried to plant in your home, bazalwane, to destroy, to eat from ukudla kwakho, even imali yakho, bazalwane. Perhaps we are sebenza kodwa umholo wakho awazi ukuthi uyaphi. We are sebenza kodwa mekuphe kushaya umhla ka 5, hayi ayisekho imali, ngathi uwallet wakho uyavuza uneyimbobo, imali imane inyamalali, iyanyamalali imali, kuyanyamalala ukudla endlini. Awazi nje ukuthi usebenzelani. It's like you are working backwards, bangwele. Plead the blood of Jesus Christ over your home. Go to every room, bangwele. Go to every room and plead the blood of Jesus Christ over your home. In Jesus' mighty name. If you wish, you command nje empompini uwathandazele and pray over that water. Plead the blood of Jesus Christ over that water. Just what? Don't go to umthandazo. Amanzi. We are priests and we are kings. And just uthandaze uwathele lawo manzi in your home and plead the blood of Jesus Christ. bazalwane, so that anything that the enemy had tried to plant, bazalwane, there are monitoring spirits. God is saying, namhlanje, there are monitoring spirits that follow people, God's people, wherever you are, they are. There are monitoring spirits, monitoring what you do, wherever you are. For instance, impugani bazalwane, utholu ulandelwa impugani nje, ulandelwa impugani, uthi uthi busathe uyashala impugani, kodwa impugani lokho ikulandela nje. Sometimes that can be a monitoring spirit, bazalwane. So plead the blood of Jesus over your home. Plead the blood of Jesus over yourself. And may those monitoring spirits, we gouge out the eyes of those monitoring spirits in the mighty name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Let every monitoring spirit fall down and die now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every dark spirit, every spirit, every diabolical spirit that comes from the kingdom of darkness, we plead the blood of Jesus over our home, and we command every dark spirit to leave our homes right now. Leave our workplaces in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every spirit from the kingdom of darkness. We command you to leave our home. We command you to die, fall down and die, never to resurrect. In the mighty name of Jesus, sihlakaza yonke ama meetings imhlangano, siyawahlakaza yonke imhlangano from the kingdom of darkness, all wickedness, siyayihlakaza namhlanje ehlangene ngamagama ey'ngane zikaJehova sezulwini. Siyayihlakaza leyo mhlangano namhlanje ngegama likaJesu, ingaphinde ihlangane. We call on the fire of God to burn every evil altar wherever it is in the mighty name of Jesus. We call on the fire of God to burn every evil altar in the mighty name of Jesus. Our God is a consuming fire. Burn to ashes every evil altar that is coming against the ministry of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name, we plead the blood of Jesus, and we build up altars that offer up prayer to our heavenly Father in the mighty name of Jesus. We raise up altars in our homes that raise prayers to our heavenly Father in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Isaiah 61 verse 3, and provide for those who grieve in Zion, to bestow on them a crown of beauty instead of ashes, the oil of joy instead of mourning. To bestow on them a crown of beauty instead of ashes. Bazalwane, we are here to remind, to be reminded by the word of God. Ukuthi uNkulunkulu uyakwazi ukurestore. God can restore. Whatever has been lost in our lives, God restores. If it is physical beauty, He restores. If it is youth, He restores. If it is wealth, He restores. Whatever, your life shall be filled with beauty instead of ashes, Bangwele. Whatever you have lost because of the canker worm, God is saying, I'm saying, He is restoring. And wherever you are, beauty shall come up. You shall be beautiful. As well, I'm reminded of Job, where that he was blessed in such a way that even his daughters and his sons were beautiful. His sons were handsome, and his daughters were beautiful in the land. God is saying He's restoring your beauty physically and emotionally, bangwele, spiritually, wherever you are, God's beauty shall shine, and the world shall see your beauty in the mighty name of Jesus, to the glory of God. And so salvation will come to others as well, because they will see the beauty. They will see God's beauty. But unuke kamnandi iphunga elinoka mnandi shungagcobeli lutho but uzonuka kamnandi. Why? Because you are walking with God's Holy Spirit. Bazalwane abantu baxake ukuthi yini bazoze bakubuze bathi yini loyigcobayo mtshele bantwana ukuthi it is the blood of Jesus Christ. Wherever you are. It is the blood of Jesus Christ. It is the blood of Jesus Christ. Beauty instead of ashes. Beauty. Because God's beauty shall, your children shall be blessed. They shall be beautiful. Your wealth, God giving you exciting and wonderful ideas. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because God is saying he's restoring us. In the mighty name of Jesus. Our God is restoring us. Whatever we had lost, our Father is restoring us in the mighty name of Jesus. And provide for those who grieve in Zion to bestow on them a crown of beauty instead of ashes, the oil of joy. We know Utumoye Ngwene Bazalwane is represented by oil Bangwene, the oil of joy Bazalwane, not just happiness, but joy Bangwene. Joy is when, even when you don't have anything or petting a sandal, but you are filled. You are filled, Utwene. You are content, Bazalwane, because why? God's Holy Spirit is inside of us. God's Holy Spirit walks with us, Bazalwane, in the mighty name of Jesus. Instead of mourning and a garment of praise, wherever we are, we are not mourning, we are not complaining, we are not crying, Bazalwane, but we are praising God because we know who he is. But there is peace, Bazalwane. Ayiko into ezula ukthula okuvelezulwini. To have God's peace, Bangwen, you can't buy it. Just to have, was glad of soup. Kisho mesel kali washu kotele, washu kali lan. Goba pena, was bam nandu glad. He says in his word that he gives peace to those he loves, Bangwen. Instead of a spirit of despair, they will be called oaks of righteousness. He says in his word, we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. By the way, we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. A planting of the Lord for the display of his splendor. For the display of God's splendor. By the way, God's splendor will be displayed through us. Bazalwane. The planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified. This is the New King James Version. The planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified. Bazalwane. Sibizelwe ukukholwa nokukhonza uKristu Jesu. Kona noma ikuphi la esihamba khona bangcwele, abantu bazobona ukuthi lo uhamba no Jesu Christ. Lo uhamba no Jesu, so that he may be glorified. And when he is glorified, then salvation comes. Bangwe. In the mighty name of Jesus. We preach without even opening our mouths. Just by our presence. Bangwe. Because God's presence is with us. We preach without speaking. Abantu bayabona ukuthi khona khona la, and then noma beyabuza kodwa ngoba umoya ngcwele uyazi our thoughts, then he will present himself, because Jesus says I stand at the door knocking. Abantu mabasindiswe namhlanje kuseni ngawe, abantu abasindiswe ngomkhuleko wakho, abantu abasindiswe ngokuhamba kwakho, abantu abasindiswe by the words that you speak. But we're speaking life wherever you are. Speak life wherever you are, Bazalwane. Don't join in the gossip. Don't join in the complaining. Speak life wherever you are, Bazalwane. Let us continue praying for salvation. Heavenly Father, we come to you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. our Lord and Savior. Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for your love. You even sent your only begotten Son to die for us on the cross. Father, we pray for salvation in our communities. We pray that your people, oh God, receive salvation and they receive Christ Jesus as Lord, Savior, and Messiah in the world, Heavenly Father. We pray for our families, oh God. We pray, Baba Otoyengwele, that you fill us with your Holy Spirit, directing us what to do, where to go, Heavenly Father. We receive you, God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Wherever you are, join us. Namhlanje, and just say this word. Heavenly Father, I come to you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I believe in my heart that Jesus Christ is the Messiah. I believe in my heart that Christ Jesus died on the cross for my sins. He died, he was buried, he was in the tomb, and on the third day he rose from the dead, and he ascended to heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of God the Father, where he intercedes for his people. I receive Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior today and forevermore. Fill me, O God, with your Holy Spirit. Give me, O Father, wisdom from heaven in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Renew my mind, O Father. Renew my thinking, O Lord. I want to be like Christ Jesus. Help me to live a life that is worthy of you, O God, in Jesus' mighty name. Order my steps from today onwards in Jesus' mighty name until Jesus comes back. The mighty name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen. Siyabonga bazalwane. Siyabonga izwi elimnandi kangaka. Please share with your loved ones. Please share with every person that you know. Please share with God's people, Bangwele, in the mighty name of Jesus. The desire of our God is that we all are saved, Bazalwane, that we all spend eternity in heaven, Bangwele. And so we speak God's heavenly blessings upon you and your family and your community over the world. In the mighty name of Jesus, even as we are going to be voting, may there be peace in our country. In Jesus' mighty name, be blessed. Amen.